listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
From the Kari Feinstein Style Lounge in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com. And streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's America's Best Dance Crew After Show.
Hey guys, what is happening? Welcome to America's Best Dance Crew, live at MTV Gifting Suites. So, we were actually just at MTV and WB, Ashley and I, on Friday, right?
Yes, yes.
So that was pretty fun.
It was a lot of fun. I wish I was there.
Sarah usually is, but she was in Hawaii. So you can't complain too much.
I can't complain, no.
I wish I was in Hawaii, but whatever. I was stuck watching America's Best Dance Crew.
I'll take you one time.
I would love that. But guys, Bing is for doing it. We are doing America's Best Dance Crew. And I am joined by, as always, the lovely Sarah Mendoza.
Aloha.
Ashley Gray.
Hey guys, what's up?
And I am Dave Klein in the booth today. We have both Ronnie Jr. and Marissa.
Hey, what's up guys? I'm excited.
A double team. Marissa was with us too on Friday.
She was.
She's a rock star.
Yes, I was. I had so much fun there. And
so,
I continue to have fun there.
Let's jump in and get started, guys, with the introductory dance to LMFAO. What did you guys think?
LMFAO. They are the party crew, right?
Yeah.
So that was a very high energy performance. Like that music group. Mm-hmm. What I saw that they haven't really done before is they actually intermix all the crews in that performance for each dance section. It wasn't like this crew's going to do that section and that crew's going to do that section. It was all the crews intermixed throughout the whole song, which I thought was pretty cool.
They danced like a family. They looked like one big group instead of, you know, four different groups, so I noticed that too.
I noticed that they all kind of came in first. They sort of had their introductory come-ins, and it started with, I believe, RNG, right in Next Generation. They were doing some tutting there at the beginning. Mm-hmm. And then Most Wanted crew came in doing some parkour-style tricks over boxes, which was pretty cool.
Yeah,
I appreciated
cool.
all that. I love the parkour. And then Flavas came in doing their gymnastics and cheerleading.
Don't forget that we are streaming live at the Kari Style Lounge here in Hollywood.
Yes, guys, we are here at
the
MTV Gifting Suites.
Celebrity Lounge.
Because we are
celebrities.
For the day.
And we're getting gifts all day long, like this cup which has no water in it. So, so then after that, after all that, Electrolytes came in with the robot heads on. So that was cool. What did you guys think of the robot head dancing?
That was my favorite part. It was Electrolytes and another crew, too.
Yeah, I think some Most Wanted was in there because they were doing a little breaking. I think Most Wanted is the only crew left that can do some breakdance elements.
I thought that was really cool, and it was a little precursor to what we were going to see later with the robot challenge, which
we'll talk about in a bit.
So, yeah, they were doing some shuffle step there, which is typical. You think LMFAO, you think shuffle steps. They were doing the shuffle step. They were doing this. I think they were doing a little sponge bobbing in there. And they also did, there was a cool b-boy move in the middle. The guy did a flare, and he went into what looked like, it was hard to see from the top view, but he looked into halos, and that's when you are kicking your legs out around you while you're spinning on your head at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So for people who sort of know terms, it's like a mix of a windmill and a head spin. It's kind of like the in-between is called halos. It was cool to see that. It's a really difficult move, so the fact that he was pulling that off, I was impressed with it. And then he ended it with a freeze. So it was good. I liked the intro. I thought it was a great intro.
The part that I liked the best is when one of the girls was walking up the steps on her hands.
Yeah.
That
that's right.
So cool. Right. I was like, wow. And then she was up there for a long time.
Yeah.
It had to be like, probably only 15 seconds, but that's a long time to hold your, self.
Strong,
your whole body on your arm.
Strong young woman there.
Yeah.
So she was going up on her hands, and all of a sudden the door flies open, and that's when the robot starts
down. And she not
really
only,
cool intro.
It wasn't only like on one step. She actually climbed the step. So I was like, dang, girl.
You know, that's definitely, that's something when I was practicing parkour, we would try and practice that, and not everybody could do that, climbing upstairs on your hand on a handstand. So it was great. It was impressive that she could do that. And I think that part of the reason I like this intro so much, personally, is because there are less crews, so it allows...
Right.
It's hard to choreograph when you have 10 different crews or
different
five
dance
different
styles,
crews.
And you can't really, you have to like mesh all of them together. It's not like, you know, so it's So it's better.
I feel like, yeah, you can bring in crews as singular units and really highlight their separate elements, mm-hmm. too, when you don't have mm-hmm. so much to work with so little time. I think yeah. it's right. a little bit easier to choreograph
there's,
all that.
There's more time to showcase people in mm-hmm. certain
right.
groups.
Now, Shonique, if you're watching, let us know. Shonique was with us last week.
Yes,
so
shout out to Shonique.
She's a choreographer. choreographer for
and
America's
she,
Best Dance
you know,
Crew.
She's coming back on our show, too, in a couple weeks.
Oh, yeah, will she be
we'll
back?
We'll have her back
oh.
again for her expertise.
And her partner. Lynette,
yeah. partner. Yeah.
That's
Lizette.
Right. So she'll be back. So Lizette. Stay tuned when she comes back. Keep watching and listening. So, guys, let's move on then to our first crew of the night. It was
most
the question
wanted.
Was hey, most
Dave,
wanted crew safe?
Dave, before you start, we actually have an exciting vendor to show
oh,
you guys.
Okay.
Awesome. So please welcome them.
All right, guys. Welcome. We have a vendor coming in from the gifting suites.
Come
Hi
on
there.
Up and
come
join
on
us,
up.
Girl. I love those earrings.
Look at those
Let's
earrings.
Put them right here. Those are so
Center
amazing.
Stage.
Center
yeah.
stage.
I want to try
Very
them on.
Very pretty. Oh, I like the little things.
Thank you.
Ah. Ooh, Wings Hawaii. I was actually wow. in Hawaii last week. Is your company based from the island?
Yeah.
And you brought it over here?
We're actually based on Maui.
Oh, nice.
Oh, wow. What islands were you on?
I was on Oahu, but I've been to Maui for a little bit. I used to live on Oahu.
Awesome. Maui. We used to live on Oahu, too. All three of my business partners and I went to college at the University of Hawaii.
Oh,
that's where
so
you were, too.
I. Wow. So you wait till I'm right here. Look at you. You're here in California. You have this amazing business that's come out. Tell us about your business.
Well, I was studying sculpture at the University of Hawaii, and I was making jewelry. And with a really great set of friends and a really encouraging family, I ended up starting a business and talking my two best friends into going into business with me. And we all design and make all of the stuff ourselves.
Now, is it all based off of sort of that tropical element? Because I see you have seashells and you have various other shells as part of the earrings. Did you decide to incorporate that as a Hawaii-style theme?
Well, picking shells is probably like the world's favorite pastime, so it kind of lends easily to wanting to make jewelry with it. A lot of the times, going out and picking shells inspires actual pieces. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
These are gorgeous.
It's more exciting to go and pick the shells and decide what to make with it rather than like maybe go to a store and buy materials.
Now, yeah, I know I used to do that all the time when I was a kid. And I'm sure I as well as visited Maui. I think it's actually my favorite Hawaiian island. And it's beautiful, so I'm sure you guys have shells there that you can't find anywhere else.
We do, and you have to be really lucky, too, to find shells there. You have to know just the spots to go to.
So you actually bring it over from Hawaii, then?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
So we brought our whole business with us. We actually make clothing and bikinis and purses.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
We silk screen all of our original artwork onto T-shirts and tank tops and tote bags. And everything we do is in an eco-conscious and friendly way.
How
so
fun.
Now, can you tell us about these particular pieces you brought with us?
Well, those
I was stealing this one over here. I'll give it back to you now.
These particular shells right here are called sunrise shells, and they're endemic to Hawaii. So that means they're not found anywhere else in the world.
Oh,
they are very
gorgeous.
Pretty. It's a nice pink and purple mix there.
Oh, you like that, Dave? You want to wear them
I
for
love
us?
It. If only I had holes in my ears, I could wear them.
But the rings are entirely hand fabricated, so we do all of our own findings. So everything starts out as raw materials, and we feel like that helps us stand apart from other pieces that are just put together.
All
so
right.
We actually make everything
Well,
from
they're
scratch.
So Gorgeous. Beautiful. Tell all of our viewers where we can find them, where we can actually purchase them.
Well, you can find our store on the North Shore of Maui on 71 Baldwin Avenue. Or you can visit us on the web at www.wingshawaii.com.
Now, awesome. I say you go to Hawaii because what a perfect excuse to visit Hawaii like Sarah did, especially Maui, which is probably the best island, I think.
Right.
It's
so
awesome.
Beautiful.
I say it's a great excuse to go.
Support local businesses there in Hawaii. It's a great excuse to go hit the beaches. Well,
awesome.
Thanks so much for joining
Thank
us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
A Twitter
so much.
That you want to promote?
Our Twitter is at Wings Hawaii.
At Wings Hawaii.
At Wings Hawaii.
Follow
Thank
at
you so
Wings
much.
Hawaii.
Thank
you All right. Thank
so
you.
Much.
It was nice to meet you.
Aloha.
Aloha. I feel like I never left Hawaii because we've got this.
I know.
On
this was
awesome.
How perfect was this
right.
for you, Sarah? This was the perfect
Thank
guest to have on.
Honestly, we get to continue that aloha spirit.
All right. So let us move on then to most wanted crew. They were in contention. Woo! Was it going to be most wanted crew who was safe or rated next generation who was safe?
Mm-hmm.
Most wanted crew was safe, which I was happy about because their dance last week was amazing.
Really?
Their suit dance.
Oh, yeah, last week.
It was incredible. They had their suits popping, and it was really style, so I was glad they were safe. And what did you guys think about their dance this week?
Too disturbing.
It's a family
show. I love you, but...
Hey, at least it wasn't Ape Flava's doing it, okay?
But the thing is, maybe I'm old-fashioned, but this is a family show. I don't think that you should have handprints on your crotch area when you have, you know, Ape Flava's who are 10 to 12 years old. I wouldn't want my little kids looking at that. You know, I just thought it was too risque for my liking.
You know what, though? I think the challenge was that they were supposed to take the catwalk, wiggle-inspired runway modeling, and that is the entire music video, is that. And they're in thongs in the whole music video.
Yeah,
so I felt like they had to do that sort of nod. And I don't know. I found it humorous that they stripped their pants once, and I thought that was going to be it, or maybe they take off their shirt, and then they stripped their pants twice. And
they
I was so wowed. I was like, wow, two pants to rips.
I'm a girl, and I did not say wow. I was like, whoa.
Well, I think I agree a little bit more with Dave on this because it was the challenge they were given, and they couldn't choose, you know, what artist they were going to be, you know, whose song they were going to be doing. And LMFAO is kind of that scandalous kind of group. So for the challenge that they were given, I think they did their best in emulating that aura of LMFAO and throwing in those funny gimmicks. The handprint was kind of weird for me, right, girls?
Like,
I agree. But I thought it was cool that it was a progression of, like, catwalk. All right, we're stripping down, and, like, one by one, articles of clothing are coming off. And in the end, it was funny when he was, like, trying to take it off, but he had nothing underneath, so he couldn't anymore. And he was just like, oh, I guess I can't remove my...
Oh, see, I actually didn't quite get that joke at the end, so I'm glad that you got that for me.
I didn't either. I'm like, why are they digging in his underwear?
I figured it was like he was trying to get his thong off or something.
Because there was a certain lyric when it was about them taking off their clothes. So every time that lyric would come up, they'd rip off their pants.
Right.
Now, at the last part, they had nothing to rip off, and that's why he was, like, pretending to be struggling.
Okay.
And he pulled off whatever he had underneath.
I appreciate that point. Yeah. Thank you.
He didn't know that because I was lost.
I guess I'm the expert in stripping.
Yes.
You know?
I would like to point out some of the dance moments on it, other than their general choreography, which I thought was pretty on point. There was a breaking moment where the guy... They kind of had two elements. One guy came off to the side and did a little breaking. He did a single CC. Mm-hmm. Not too impressive for breakdancers, but it was clean. And then on the other side, the guy on the other side did a little up-top dance. They had the little push-out workout moment where they were doing their push-ups to kind of work out.
I like that.
Which was pretty funny. And then they had another joke, because their whole thing was humor this time. They had the thing where the music stopped and the guy did the peace sign where someone was pulling up his shirt.
Yeah.
So I asked them, I actually interviewed them last week, and I asked them if they were using the Step Boys for inspiration. And
they said they're funny guys.
Right. They said Step Boys are funny, but this is a chance to show this side of their crew. So they do like humor and they do that. So
I admit it was very entertaining. I love the catwalk. I thought it was fierce. I was like, wait, am I watching America's Next Top Model or America's Best Dance Crew? I mean, it was fierce. I loved it. For my taste, and I agree with the little mama, it was just a little bit too disturbing. And I think that, you know, they're a creative group. They could have, you know, expressed that in another way.
But Lil Mama's not always right because she said the guy was doing a bench press for that move. That wasn't a bench press. That was a pec deck. That's called the pec deck when you do that. It's called
Dave
the pec deck,
guys. Because I know me, I don't know all the technical.
I mean, that's not even a dance move. It's just he was emulating a workout thing, and it was the pec deck. If you lift weights, that's just lifting weights.
Yeah.
I think. Yeah, they were funny, but it did take away from just how Most Wanted usually is. They're very,
there wasn't enough choreo.
Quick,
just like what JC said,
powerful, explosive, you know, movement. It's very fluid usually, and in this one, I was like waiting for things. It was funny when it came, but like it wasn't as
fluid
as usual.
I think I definitely agreed the most with JC here when he said the routine was just a little too slow.
Mm-hmm.
I guess generally I tend to agree with JC a lot, but I liked the routine. I liked it. I was entertained, and like you guys said, I just thought it was good, but it wasn't great. It didn't blow me away. It didn't wow me. It wasn't like their suit one last week, which I was like, wow, this was incredible.
Yeah.
I was just like, all right, that was pretty good. I hope I see something I like more today on the episode.
The best perk was... Who did not want to see Ian in tights? He's like such a cutie. So
Is
he? Is he really?
Oh my gosh, yes.
He can bulk up
a little bit.
Oh, Marissa agrees.
He can put on a little bit more muscle, but his little cute face, he's a cutie.
He's adorable. Yeah. I want to say one more thing before we move on to the next route about it being slow. It was also the opening that was I don't know if you guys remember the opening, but they kind of just stood there and, like, I think one of them kind of looked like they were blowing a kiss.
Yeah.
But it's like, what kind of opening? That is the slowest opening I've ever seen from any of the crews.
Yeah.
Most people just, like, come at it at the beginning of the song, and these guys would just kind of, like, pose a little bit and, like, did another pose.
They were getting ready for that catwalk
girl.
Yeah.
So next week what they should do is just stand there for the first 10 beats and just be like, and then jump in. That'll be a slow start. Before we do move on, though, I do want to say that we do provide this content completely for free. So any way you guys can help support us would be amazing, whether that be going to iTunes and commenting or rating our show, or going to YouTube. You can comment and rate us, and we'll respond to your comments. We love reading them. Or go to AfterBuzzTV.com, where you can watch us live generally every single week on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. Pacific time. Right now we're live at the Gifting Suites MTV, but you can watch us live. You can join in on the chat roll, and we'll interact with
Download
you.
Download us for free on iTunes.
And we always have guests on the show as often as we can. And if you guys are on the live chat, we will ask your questions for you to our guests.
Definitely.
So definitely come check us out. So let's move on then to
my favorite group. One of my favorite
Electrolytes.
Yes.
Electrolytes and A Flavas were up in contention. And I was surprised here because Electrolytes was my favorite crew last week, but A Flavas is so popular that I was kind of like, oh crap, Electrolytes is up against A Flavas. That means Electrolytes is going to be in the bottom.
Yeah.
But Electrolytes weren't. They were safe, and A Flavas was in the bottom. So I was a little surprised by that because I just thought A Flavas was so popular.
I don't think so, because I think that Electrolytes were the underdogs throughout the beginning of the competition, but now they're proving themselves.
Yeah.
So they're now on top. So I
go back. You
it.
Can see I've liked them ever since the beginning. They've been one of my favorites.
Do you think that they purposely put them in the bottom, though, because they wanted it to be the young groups against each other? I thought it was something like that.
I do kind of wonder that with shows like this at times, like if it really is how popular it is. But from what I've seen on when I look at YouTube comments and stuff like that, it seems like most Wanna Crew has pretty much always been safe, and they are really popular. Because the week that they were flubbing and messing up, I would have expected them been in the bottom. And I think most people would have if you just watched their performance, and the judges would have put them there, but they weren't.
Right.
So
They have a large fan base. They're from L.A. Everyone loves them.
And then we've also seen Fanny Pack consistently on the bottom, which I'm sure is because people don't want to see another crew back again.
Yeah.
As good as Fanny Pack is.
We love you, Fanny Pack.
but then I don't know, because it is fun to see, oh, my God, it's the kids facing each other. So I definitely see what you're saying.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you think? Do you think it was, like, on purpose?
Honestly, I thought they were going to do that because they would probably only want one kid group in the top three.
Yeah.
You know?
It makes sense.
It does. And then with Electrolytes, I heard what you were saying, girl, about Electrolytes being the underdogs. I never saw them as the underdogs. But maybe that's because I was here, Dave, how much he loves them, you know?
I think it's just like online people weren't supporting them very much. They were like, oh, Electrolytes.
Oh, really?
And we actually had a comment on one of our videos, like, you're stupid. How could you think Electrolytes is going to go far? Someone commented on our video.
I know.
Look at us now. How dumb are we now?
Top three, Electrolytes. They've been very consistent. I think they deserve to be there.
I do too. So, all right, let's
especially
go on to this
tonight.
Dance. Champagne Shower was their dance, and their challenge was to do the robot and transform into a giant robot. I think, I'm saying it right now, this was my favorite dance of the night. Once again, they destroyed it. They killed it. And they keep on showing that they can do so many different styles. Tonight, they were doing all popping and robot-style dancing, and they were just killing it. And they weren't only doing that. Unlike when they let the other dance, which was, what was the one where they were doing the martial arts dance?
The
Subway one? Is that it?
Not the Subway one. It was like the martial arts dance style.
I think that was
style.
The one after the Subway.
They're doing handstands. It was after the Subway. Mm-hmm. I will remember and come back to it. But for that one, I thought they let the challenge own them because they were only doing that style of dance.
Yeah. Right.
This one, they were doing variations. They had a great intro with Marcus head sliding in after
that
the robot.
That was amazing.
And it's also the roboting stuff they were doing looked good. It was really tight. So it was also a good intro in that regard without the blow up. But they had great blow-ups throughout. They had the hat spin trick. They had great tricking.
Dave, hey, we actually have a special guest. His name is Ryan Ocho. He is from the Parrot Kings. He's actually a humongous fan of America's Best Dancers.
All right. Welcome on.
There,
so big of a fan that he watched the latest episode on the plane last night.
Oh. You watched it on the plane.
What's up?
So give
What's
him
up?
A big welcome.
Nice to meet you, Dave.
Hello. How are you? Sarah. Nice to meet you, Ryan.
Join us. Put your...
Yes.
You are.
We would love to hear you.
Everyone
can all hear you.
All right, Ryan, so we're talking right now about Electrolytes performance. What did you think about the Electrolytes last night?
Electrolytes.
Can you put that a little closer?
Like here.
Yes.
There we go.
I've never done this before.
There you go.
First time.
Electrolytes. They actually, I thought they were the best ones last night.
Yeah.
But, you know, Most Wanted crew, they're my favorite. They're my favorite this season. I still think that they can bring it and they can win it all.
Now, awesome. Are you from the LA area? Is that why? Because they teach dancing, or is that just because of all their performances?
Yeah. I live in LA. I like all the LA crews. The Jabberwockies were from San Diego, and that's where I was born. Not only were they the best crew of America's Best Dance Crew ever, but, you know, they're SD, and I like the SD crews, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So right. I'm not used to this.
No, it's okay. You're doing great. What was it about Electrolytes' performance last night that you liked? It was the robot challenge.
They worked really, really hard, you know, and all season they've been improving all season, mm-hmm. and I think last night's performance was great. They just put it all into it, you know?
I mean, I totally agree. I was saying just before you came on that I thought they had the best dance of the night. Mm-hmm. What did you girls think of it?
I think that the transitions were so smooth. And you know that it's their challenge was to do the robot. And you know how the robot is really, really stiff?
Yeah.
But it didn't look stiff. It looked so effortless when they were dancing. And I was like, dang. I went home and I practiced the robot. And I got, because I was trying
all right,
to, like,
there
do
we
it.
Go.
Like, girl, you don't need to practice. You got that.
No, I do.
You got that.
And it's like, I always learned to do it so stiff. But it's like, they just looked so effortless when they were doing it. Everything was just like... Yeah, I can't do it. Like, I need lessons.
A lot of us learning how to pop. Like, you have to pop your muscles, and that's sort of how you do it. I'm not very good at it, but that's what I learned.
You tried to build a giant robot.
I did. With me and my cat.
By herself.
No, exactly. My cat. I used my cat.
Oh, my cat. Stood on her cat.
You know, I thought it was cool, too, and it reminded me of Transformers, the movie, because it was like all these moving pieces coming together, and they're forming this big robot in the center, and they didn't do it once. The judges pointed out that they actually did it three times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Usually with challenges, they'll just knock it out once within their performance, but these guys are like, we're going to show you three different ways to do this right now.
They totally handled it.
That was one of the cool things was when they had two dancers on the side with someone else on their shoulders, and the people on the shoulders were doing the robot spins. So that was really cool.
Right.
My comparison I made was I thought of Voltron, I guess, but and then I told them, was it like Voltron? And they were like,
Voltron?
No, it's like Transformers. So they thought Transformers too.
Yeah.
You guys have
it's
right.
It's a generation thing, I think. Maybe.
I guess it's a generational thing, but I loved it.
Man, you.
No. Another cool thing that we should point out that they did was when Sal was shaking the bottle and they had the champagne cork pop
human
up.
Human cork.
Oh, yeah,
that was
human
awesome.
Cork.
Creativity
that was
in
a good
dance.
Part.
So that was definitely like a cool element.
And they also did that head slide in, or
Marcus.
Yeah,
Marcus
the head slide.
Right off the top.
Yeah, right off the top after the good choreo.
And we're all like, wait, he knows how to do that?
I know, I'm like, wait, is that his head?
What about when he was on the shoulders and then he spun off like into the tuck?
That was crazy.
Very acrobatic.
You know what we didn't mention is that Quest crew was actually helping all these guys.
Yeah, that's right.
With their performances this week. And when he did the head spin, it reminded me of Ryan and Mai from Quest crew, because that's what he's known for, is doing those weird like head hops and head glides. So he was probably pulling for them.
I'm sure, yeah. They were like, this is what you need to do.
And it was LMFAO's week.
Yeah.
They're my favorite.
Great. Actually, I've
What's your favorite LMFAO song, then?
I mean, Party Rock Anthem. Fantastic, but Sexy and I Know It.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, so we were just...
Do the wiggle.
Just arguing here before you got here about Most Wanted Crew's performance to Sexy and I Know It. What did you think of the performance?
Like the judges said, well, you know, JC liked it, and so did Lil Mama, but Dietrich liked it. JC didn't really like it. I kind of agreed with him, you know, compared to, you know, their previous dances. I thought they could have did a little bit better, but I was happy with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was happy. I thought they had a hard challenge, though. You know, that was kind of
I think
tough.
It would have been up Step Boys' alley. Step Boys would have nailed that off, like, knocked it out of the park.
Yeah, but, you know, they did have a hard challenge, but I thought they did good enough. To move on to
did
next
you think
week.
It was a little bit too risque?
Nah.
Nothing too risque.
So I guess the guys here, because I didn't think it was
like,
too risque either, were like, that's cool, whatever.
Yeah, that was cool, you know?
Yeah.
I guess I have a man's mind.
Ashley's just fragile. I know, she's that's fragile.
I didn't like it. It was too much for my eye.
Earmuffs. But you got to see Ian. You got to see Ian with like nothing on,
yeah,
right? So
yeah,
that's
you
fun.
Like that.
Ian, he's cute. He's a cutie.
Look at him. Look at him calling you out.
I know you like that.
So I do want to know though, outside of Most Wanted being from LA, why are they your favorite crew? What dances have you really stuck out to you?
I like the ones right in the beginning.
Yeah.
Because I mean that for me to get a to like a crew. I always look at their very first dance in the first week. Like Jabberwockies, when they did the apologize dance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was their first dance. That was just like, wow.
Yeah.
And ever since then, I always looked forward to the next week. So Most Wanted, when they did, their first dance, not only were they L.A. crew.
Yeah.
The L.A. crew, I liked their first dance, so that's what made me want to follow them.
Oh, you're like, all right. Do you dance at all?
Maybe.
Maybe
I'm building my own crew.
Oh. Like,
can we audition?
Next season, America's Best Dance Crew.
TV exclusive.
Oh, you heard it here first.
You heard it here first, guys.
Ryan and his crew coming out.
No, yeah. I'm joking. That'd be cool, though, right?
Yes, it'll be.
It's going to be his bedroom. He could join you and your cat and building
cat.
The robot.
You right.
Join Ashley's crew. They're only going to be robots. Robots and cats.
And no tight little boxers with handprints on the crotch region.
Those are prohibited.
Sorry. I know you wanted it. That's what I want to see from you guys.
Yeah.
But it's not going to be brought. All right. So let's move on to Rated Next Generation. So Rated Next Generation ended up being in the bottom this week. I was glad because last week I thought they did have one of the weaker dances, as much as I do like them from talking to them. But their dance was Sorry for Party Rocking. And the trick they were supposed to do, I'm just going to say that I interviewed them on Friday, and that trick that Quest Crew is helping them out with, they told me the name of the trick was the birthing, because it was supposed to look like you were being birthed out of something.
Yeah.
So I'm referring to it as the birthing of Rated Next Generation is the name of that dance they were supposed to do. What did you guys think of that dance? Do you want to start, Ryan?
I thought it was good. I liked it. And to be in the bottom, you have to really bring it.
You gotta bring it.
Because they'll vote you out, and especially this dance to go into the finals.
Yeah.
It has to be no joke, and they did. I mean, I really liked it, and I thought they were good enough to go next week.
Yeah. All right, great. You guys want to go next?
I'll have to disagree.
Yeah.
As much as I love RNG, I'm sorry. I love RNG, but I think that they could have done better, especially since they're in the bottom too.
I think so too.
It was in comparison to the other crews, because the other crews, for me, really knocked it out this week. They didn't bring it as hard.
Yeah.
See, I'm easy. I'm easy. I'm a nice guy.
Yeah, like, all right. That
I'm
was
a
fun.
Band.
I did like the story element that they brought to the dancing. Mm-hmm. However, I will agree with you. I thought it wasn't as good as it could have been.
Yeah.
I know they did the jump through when the one girl jumped through the arms. I think it was called a dolphin.
That
dolphin
was cool,
dive.
That
was the coolest.
Well, the
part,
one through
though.
The arms was the birthing.
Oh, that was
that
the
was
birthing.
The birthing. The dolphin dive was just when they were in the front and just basically did like a front roll, but they jumped into their
well,
front roll.
Well, the birthing, that was the only cool thing that I thought,
but,
gave
but even
flavor.
For the birthing, they didn't land it.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
Yeah.
They did it a couple on each side for the birthing.
So awkward,
let's just make this the most awkward talk right now about this. The birthing of RNG on the sides as the members were birthed. I noticed that it looked like she didn't keep her arms wide enough, or one of them didn't have their arms open enough, so it was a little sloppy looking.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's what it was they kind of had to disconnect their arms because it's supposed to be connected.
Right.
I kind of think that's what happened. Unlike JC, he said the finger tutting that that Bailey did was sloppy in the beginning.
Was.
I thought it was all right, though.
It was
though.
Sloppy.
He was like, it was terrible.
I didn't like it.
I thought it was okay, but I did like the concept that they kind of broke away for him in the middle to do it. I thought it was a good concept. Also, they had a fun chest bump in the beginning, I'll say. I guess the whole time they were trying to do this, like this whole idea of rocking, and as JC said, it was sort of the idea of Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Right.
Because they had the mom, and she went away, so they're all partying because they had the chance to. So I thought the theme was good. Like Sarah, I thought it was just okay. I didn't think it was the best thing they've done.
No, I didn't think it was the best, but I thought it was good enough.
RNG is they're a young team, and they definitely have grown since the first episode.
Since their birth.
And it's so weird because when the judges were giving their critique, The judges sounded like they were giving them their farewell speech.
Like you
it was
tell.
Like, well, you guys, you know, I love you on the show. And I was like, oh, they're gone. Because I can just tell already by the judges'
so
response.
You were there actually live watching, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
How long did it take them to deliver it? I've just been wondering because I've been sticking around the whole time.
Actually, this time didn't take long at all. That's right, because everyone backstage, too, we were like, yeah, we already know RNG's going to go because of how the judges responded. And then as soon as they, you know, it took probably like 5 minutes. And normally it's like 15 or even 20
for them
sometimes.
To talk about it.
Yeah. But it took them, it was really
Well, I mean, A-Flavors went afterwards. What if A-Flavors went afterwards and they were just like doo-doo?
They're so cool.
<they're terrible.
laughs>
Doo-doo. Yeah.
I think no matter what, we're at the point in the season where we're already so attached to every single group, including RNG. It's tough to see them go.
Yeah.
You know, like.
Well, I think it's also harder now that we've been going backstage and talking to them. Right. We're like, no, we know them. We don't want them to go.
I
like those guys.
Yeah, exactly.
We love all of the crews, but this, you know, we have to give our opinion.
Yeah. It makes it harder.
Your negative opinions.
I hate being negative because I know them, but I have to point things out.
Yeah.
So then let's move on then to the other crew at the bottom, which was 8 Flavas. And they were dancing to my favorite song as well, Party Rock Anthem. Which, I love it. I love the music video for Party Rock Anthem, so I was excited to see what they were going to do. And their challenge was to do the SpongeBob and do impressive blow-ups. And what did you girls think of it?
Can you explain the impressive blow-ups? I didn't get that part.
Was it like... Was
An
it
impressive blow-up is like a front flip or some sort of big trick.
And they're known for that, yeah.
Yeah, they're
the
known
redhead. She's really good at that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it the... What was the... I don't know the technical term for this, but it was when it looked like she pushed the girl, but it...
It's actually something Quest Crew came up with. As they said, they came up with it and did it for the first time ever during America's Best
Fantastic.
Dance Crew.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
She like actually flipped her over, but it looked like a push.
Well,
from
it's
the
like
front.
So. What happens is the person jumps up and does a backflip, but while they're in doing their backflip, someone else shoves them to the side. So it just looks like
they actually
it just physically shoves them, so they're moving sideways as they're doing their flip, and it's just called a push flip.
I actually was on an airplane watching America's Best Dance Crew yesterday. And I was watching that dance on the plane, and it was all quiet. And all of a sudden, I was watching 8 Flavas, and they did the flip. And me and my dad jumped out of our seat. Oh, yeah! Oh, did you? And everyone looked at us like,
what's
you know,
going on?
What's going on this plane? Please, going down!
It was awesome, though, you know?
Yeah.
And Dietrich said that when they initially had created that move, it was just them flipping over one person. But 8 Flavas, they did it over 3 people.
Here's some background, sorry, Dietrich, from when I practice with them sometimes. They've been working on doing it so there's 2 people, and there's someone in the middle who shoves 2 people each way.
Oh, yeah.
That's what
Quest
is working on right now, so there's 2 people going in separate directions.
That's cool.
So that'll be cool to see. I mean, maybe they've already done it live
scary.
In a performance, but I've seen them practicing that.
Hopefully at the Movie Awards.
Yeah, that would be sick.
Yeah.
That would be very sick.
Hey, Dave, we have another vendor coming on.
All right.
Awesome. The vendor.
So give them a nice warm welcome.
Thank you so much.
All right.
It was nice having you, Ryan.
Yes. See you later.
Nice to meet you.
Bye.
So cool you guys are doing.
Oh, this is my favorite.
Come on.
I see nail polish.
Yay. How are you?
All right.
You put on your
So the Essie nail polish, this is perfect for me. All right, so can you tell us about Essie and your nail polish?
Yeah, absolutely. I actually work for MMLPR, and we represent Essie. Sorry.
No worries.
We will get
right
back.
There you go.
There
perfect.
Headphones falling off left and right.
Perfect.
I'm gonna stay. I might have to hold them. We represent Essie, which is like the go-to nail polish brand. It really is.
It's right.
Women love it, and it's been around since 1981, so it's been around for a really long time. And this is actually the second year we've done this event, so we're psyched to be here. This is their 2012 collection for summer. It is gorgeous. I'm actually wearing the pink one.
Oh,
you can
kind of
see it. It looks
I have
awesome.
That one.
It
so
is you so see what it looks like.
All the pink colors, but it's fantastic. It's called Cascade.
So you
Pool.
Don't even need to be here advertising because Ashley just uses
it
anyway.
I love it. I love
it. And I need some rescuing, so I'm glad you're
here. And
know.
You know,
my nails are so bad right now.
To all of our viewers, if you put, because I know I hate chipping, so if you use use Essie, just put on like three coats if you need three coats, and it will last for at least a week and a half to 2 weeks.
Absolutely.
I promise you. It's amazing.
And
I love it.
And what's great is they have the best brushes, so
you
can even do it yourself, and it's not messy. It's super easy. And
it's
like you said,
quality.
It lasts so long. Like,
yes.
I will wear this for probably 2 weeks, which is unbelievable.
And they have amazing colors. Look at these colors. They're so fun.
Now, is this a summer collection of colors?
This is the 2012 summer collection, and it's bright, it's awesome, it's colorful. Mm-hmm. It's perfect for the summer, whether you're poolside or going for a girls' night out.
Yes.
It's like, it's a fantastic collection of colors. And the names are great. This is Mojito Madness, which I love. This is Bikini Sotini, which is great. They have the best names, awesome colors.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And for girls who are scared to try a pop of color, I tell you, please, try something like this. It's a little bit more matte, so you don't have to do like an orange. And it's, I love it. I'm
addicted. I do too.
Addicted.
And I feel like when it comes to your toes, I like to take more risks. Like, I feel like I can go with brighter colors on my toes, you know? So, like, blue is fantastic, like you were saying, for your toes, orange, just, like, go for it. I totally agree.
I'm so glad.
Would blue be
a
bright color? I feel like pink would be, like, the bright color.
I mean, I'm wearing pink.
I guess it's not, like, super bright.
Yeah, I would say orange would be the brightest, I think.
Yeah. It's definitely like a showstopper, or green, something kind of out of the ordinary. I would say that's a bright one, too.
Yeah.
But, yeah, they're fantastic colors. You can get them at Rite Aid, CVS, actually Bliss right here in the hotel carries it.
Oh,
if you go into just about any nail salon, you know, they obviously have Essie on the shelves.
Definitely.
So it's fantastic, and it's the go-to brand. It's great, yeah.
And it's a great price range, guys. So it's
absolutely.
Only about $8 if you want to go to a Walgreens, CVS, and you'll have salon-quality nail polish, right?
Yeah.
See,
your
Ashley
room.
Really does have it down. She can do all the work.
Love Essie.
I know. I love that we have Ashley here because I'm the girl that like just doesn't care about her nails.
Well, you will.
I
we
need to
get you there.
Start caring,
yeah,
apparently.
Absolutely. If you find a color you love, like you'll totally get into it. You know, it'll be your go-to color for the summer, and you'll rock it all summer long.
All summer.
We have to find you your color, and you'll.
You guys are convincing me.
Maybe green.
Let's convince Dave now and make it a group.
Yeah, really getting into it.
Guys get manicured.
Maybe for my girlfriend, I'll do that. I'll get her it.
Aww.
Yeah, she'll love it. She will love it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. It was so nice for you to come and share
your
amazing colors.
Absolutely, ladies.
Yeah,
I'll be sure to bring you some over after the show.
Did you hear that? We have. If you heard that on camera.
Here. Yeah, that's a promise on camera.
Yes, I keep my promise. I will get you guys some colors for
sure. Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank
great.
You.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, thank you.
Appreciate it.
It's great meeting you guys.
Bye.
Now, on that note, I do want to talk about Gamefly for a moment, if you ladies would let me. Let me talk about my version of what I like to do, which is video games. So, guys, if you go to Gamefly, it is like the Netscape or Netflix. It's like Netscape. It's like the internet browser of video games. It's like the Netflix for video games. So it's basically like you can just go there, order a video game. It will be delivered to you right to your door, and you can play it. So for all those awesome games that are coming out.
Can you get like RPG games there too?
Yes, you can get RPG games. So all the Final Fantasy X-2, that was a long time ago. Final Fantasy 14. You can get that. Final Fantasy 13, you can get that from there. You can order all those. Dragon's Dogma, which just came out, Diablo 3, all that you can order from there.
Yeah, see, I'm lost. I'm like, nail polish? What?
See, this
nail
is
polish?
How Dave feels when we're talking about
Yeah,
Essie.
I'm like,
this is
what?
Like the reversal here. So, guys, instead of paying $60, you can pay about, I think, $2, $3 and just rent it and try it out and play it. Or, you know, summer, usually there's not that many good games out, so why not just play them and try them as opposed to buying a crappy game? But if you want a great discount through us, go to Gamefly.com/AfterBuzzTV, and you will get a free 15-day trial to see if you like it. Go ahead, order a game, and don't pay $60 for a game. This is much cheaper. I guess if it's like Netflix, it's just something you subscribe to. So I guess you don't have a paper game. You just subscribe, and you just get infinite orders per month.
Perfect.
So that would be the way it works. Check it out. But let's get back to
Eight Flavors.
Who, Ashley, I believe you talked to them.
I did. I love them. They are so high energy, very, very, very sweet girls. And I was asking them to tell me a little bit about their challenge that they're going to be doing, and they were saying that the judges were going to be very shocked this week because, of course, the judges say that they do too much cheerleading, poses, and stunts like that, and they wanted them to incorporate a little bit more choreography into their routine. So how do you think they did this week, Dave?
You know, that's something I definitely noticed was that they had almost no cheerleading elements,
right.
Which was good for them.
It was something different.
But I like the dancing. I like what they were doing, but it was all very sloppy to me. Their break dancing they were trying was very sloppy. It's stuff that when I teach people how to break dance, which I do a lot, that's what they look like when they're first learning how to break dance, which is something that I noticed as a b-boy. That's something that I have to point out. I like that they were trying it. I was glad they were trying it. But they were also messing up a lot of their tricks, too, like a lot of their blow-up tricks. So, for example, that trick that we're talking about, the backflip push, I noticed right away that she didn't land the trick. And it was a cool trick, and I'm glad they tried it, but when you're on a show like this, you do have to point it out that they're not landing if you don't land a trick. Right. So it sucks. I can't do it. I'm not going to say I can, but I do have to point out that they didn't do it. But I will say that their shuffling looked really good. All their shuffle stepping, the sponge bombing looked really good. Yeah, the C-steps were good. Mm-hmm. I like the middle girl when she did the kick and everybody else did a back handspring.
The toe kick.
Yeah, that was good. And then she dropped into baby freeze. That's what the freeze was called that she did.
Oh, that was adorable.
But again, as a b-boy, it was slow. She got into it really slow, and it looked a little sloppy getting into it because she's not used to doing it. And you really need to pop into a freeze to make it look clean.
Yeah, so it's just because it's not their thing. Like, breakdancing is not their thing.
I mean, it's not their thing, but they were trying to do six steps at the beginning. That's the move that they were trying to do. Uh-huh. And it was just very, very sloppy. Like, even you can get people to do it so at least it doesn't look sloppy. But to me, as a breaker, and that is my style, it was just very sloppy, and I have to point that out. I thought their shuffle steps were great, but I do have to point out their breaking was sloppy to me.
I think they did an amazing job, and I think the one reason why I think they did such a good job is because I'm not critical. I don't have a critical eye when it comes to those specific moves because that's not my expertise. So I think that they did really great. But I do agree with you that some things were a little sloppy that I did catch. But overall, I think they did really good.
I guess what I'll say, sorry to cut you off, Sarah. You haven't had a chance. But something I will say is that when I first started learning how to break dance, like 5 years ago, I probably look like that, and people were like, oh, my God, you can break dance. This is amazing.
Yeah.
And I was like, I know I'm not good because I've seen what people are good look like, but it really is just having that eye because it's something that I've been doing for so long now. I can just catch it right away and be like, oh, that's really sloppy to me because that is my style. That is my expertise. So I have to point that out.
I love how Dave is so technical with all these terms. You really do know your stuff.
Yeah. When it comes to breaking.
It makes me wonder if you, like, read any of these dancing books, you know, if you bought them anywhere.
Nope.
No?
Breaking is all just taught by person to person. Yeah. I mean, you can also go online to learn. But
yeah. And the one thing
from
your sessions,
right, at the studio that you, when you were actually practicing yourself, you probably picked up on these things.
Yeah. I mean, it was like, just watching other people I practice with. Yeah. That's all it is. And then going to b-boy battles, because I go to competitions too.
But I'm sure you can find dancing books and learn all the terminology.
I think on Amazon.
Yeah.
Amazon. Let's plug that.
I was just
tell us about
right
Amazon.
Over my head.
I was like, why are we talking about? Oh, okay. Amazon.
Yeah. So there probably are. If you go to Amazon.com. But the way that you should do it is go to our website, AfterBuzzTV.com. There is a link on the top right. If you click on that link, go to Amazon.com through our link, you will pay exactly the same price you were going to pay before.
Yes.
No additional cost, and you can get whatever you're going to buy in the first place. It just helps support us because we do provide this content for free. It would
support AfterBuzz.
Be very appreciated.
Please, pretty please.
Like b-boy handbooks, how to be a top b-boy of the world.
But Dave one thing Klein's that I did biography. Wanted to point out is that don't they get that challenge like 3 days before they have, well, not 3 days, but I think a week prior to their performance. So if they do
it's
seem.
Just a couple days sometimes.
Yeah, so if they
saying.
Do seem, just to credit eight flavors, if they do seem a little elementary in their tricking, I think it's because they're just learning how to really do it. Yeah.
Well, it's not necessarily to be an elementary thing, and that I do understand. Mm-hmm. If someone can't do, especially the harder moves like windmills and flares.
Especially with them being so young, but like they may not know exactly.
Well, I mean, what I will say, though, is if it's elementary moves, I understand. But six-step is, which is what they were trying to do, the most elementary breakdance move. That's the first move we teach everybody.
Mm-hmm.
So I understand that they don't know it. I understand it's difficult. But just I do have to point it out because that's my style. I have to point it out.
Well, to put it in perspective, though, it'd be like taking Dave or like a breakdancer
and do some and hardcore hip-hop.
Showing him the most elementary ballet technique.
Oh, yeah.
And having
you
him incorporated into the performance. I'm pretty sure you're going to look a little bit awkward, you know?
Look,
even if it's elementary.
And then we're going to tear Dave apart.
Look, I'm not... I'm just saying it's America's Best Dance Crew. That's why I'm not on America's Best Dance Crew, because I can't do that. But I do have to point it out, because I'm a B-boy. I notice these things. I have to point it out.
No, I got you.
I'm not
disagreeing
with you, though.
I'm just
saying. Sarah, what did you think of the dance?
I thought it was, well, I thought they were good. I agree with the sloppy note that you guys gave.
So now you're agreeing with me after all that.
Right. No, I agree, but I'm giving the reason why this is happening, although I do agree.
Dun, dun, dun.
And, for me, I already thought that RNG was going to be in the bottom. Like, if it was between them two, like, I agree that RNG should have went home. I think 8 Flavas did way better than RNG this year.
Yeah. I mean, I thought, and I guess we should talk about that now. I did think that 8 Flavas had a more dynamic dance. It was more fun to me. And that could just be because it was playing up to dance styles I like, because I like shuffle step. I think it's fun. I love b-boying, because that's who I am. So maybe it just played up to me, but I enjoyed the dance more. I just thought it was a sloppier performance than RNG's dance.
Uh-huh.
But that was so. I for me, when I was watching, I was like, it could go either way to me, because I thought 8 Flavas was sloppier, but I thought they had a better dance.
I take into account the entire season, so that's what I'm. When I agree with you, Sarah, that I knew that RNG was going home, because even though of course, we know these crews and we love them. We've come to love them. In the beginning, RNG was not my favorite group. I didn't think that they were as good as 8 Flavas. Immediately, 8 Flavas had my attention. And they were, even though they had their mishaps, they were consistent, you know? So when it comes down to RNG and 8 Flavas, I knew that RNG was going to go home.
I mean, I guess I like to think, and I said this in the very beginning, the very first competition, I think that those two dances should be all that matters for that moment. And like I was saying, what if RNG had the best dance of their season and 8 Flavas came out and they were sloppy? And I mean, maybe even worse than this, they're sloppy. It wasn't a good dance. It was their worst dance of the season. Would you really think it was justified that RNG had to go home if 8 Flavas sucked doo-doo butt? And
I love his doo-doo commentary today.
It's just a way to swear without swearing. So, I mean, so that's where I'd say, like, that's why I like to say, if RNG had totally destroyed FaZe and 8 Flavas didn't, and then I thought it would have been justified that RNG stayed, but I was okay with RNG going home.
Right. I had hoped that the showdown between them would be a little bit less obvious for me.
Yeah.
It was so obvious that 8 Flavas did a better job. It wasn't as exciting, like, oh my god, I wonder who it's going to be. It was more like, we know who's going home. No, we don't want him to go home, but it's going to happen.
So what did you guys think then, just tonight specifically, and then we'll get top three overnight, but who was your order tonight? Who were your favorite dances and least favorite?
I would say Electrolytes, then 8 Flavas, and then Most Wanted for tonight.
That's the exact order that I'm going to do.
That's the exact
order.
I had Electrolytes as my favorite, and then Most Wanted, and then 8 Flavas. And for me, again, that was just because I thought 8 Flavas was sloppy. But
he's always so.
In case you didn't catch it 5 minutes ago. But Electrolytes was my favorite, then Most Wanted. So I was actually pretty happy with the top two and bottom two this week. Yeah. Also, because last week that was who I thought should have been in the top two and bottom two. So that was also why I was happy to see that. Just based on last week's performances. Mm-hmm. So let's get to our top three overall. Now that's the top three. The top three are here. What do you guys think?
I'm very happy. I'm very pleased. If I had to choose from the beginning, from what we saw in the very beginning, who would be in the top three, honestly, it would have been them three for me.
Yeah.
Most Wanted is obviously a very talented group. They're choreographers. Okay, they're Cali, so we have to represent for them.
Westside?
Yeah.
Electrolytes, they've been very consistent. And 8 Flavas, for those little girls that they are, they pack a big punch. So
they're
I would have
sassy.
Thought the three of them from the beginning.
And I agree. Actually, two of my favorite groups from the beginning are in the final three, which are Electrolytes and 8 Flavas. So I really would have loved to see Collision Crew stay. Just because I love their dancing style, and I would have loved to see more of that.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, they went home, so Electrolytes and 8 Flavas are definitely to be expected, in my opinion. Right.
I'll say I am happy with the top three as well. I think Electrolytes, as I've been saying, is my favorite, and I think they've been killing it consistently, so I'm excited that they're on. I think Most Wanted has been doing great throughout the year, and 8 Flavas, just they're incredible, especially for their age. They've been killing it. the two crews that I kind of wish I got to see more of were Funkdation and Mixed Elements.
Funkdation.
Mixed Elements, who I thought, yeah, their first dance did kind of suck, but I saw in the battle, I thought they were great, and I thought they could have done better. I really thought that they could bring it up.
They were doo-doo butt.
They were doo-doo butt. And then Funkdation, and I guess you kind of agree with me, I thought that they had some fun dances. I wanted to see more from them.
Yeah. Right.
But I like these top three as well. Who is your guys' favorite that's left?
Oh, that's tough.
I know, I'm like,
Electrolytes.
He's known since the beginning. I don't know. It's between, for me, it's between Most Wanted and Electrolytes.
Yeah.
I don't know.
For me, it's between Electrolytes and 8 Flavors.
Yeah. And, I mean, they're all great. And we've actually had people ask us before, do we think, and I don't know if we ever got a chance to answer, and maybe we should now, do we think that this is possibly the best top four, best top three now that we've had ever in America's Best Dance Crew history, as all the crews. There's no specific one that we know is going to win.
Honestly, I think it's a great season. It's been, you know, ABDC is apparently back. You know, everybody's watching, tuning in, and loving it. But for some reason, I'm very attached to the first two or three seasons.
Yeah.
And I think those were, like, the glory days, I guess, for ABDC as far as the most talented crews that were in the top.
And I agree with Mendoza. I really think that I'm so attached to first and second and third season.
Yeah.
And this season, to me, it kind of started off a little slow. And I thought it was just going to be more of a boom because it was coming back after, you know, being absent for so long. And because Fanny Pack was back on, I thought it was going to just be crazy, blow me out the water the first couple of weeks, and it really didn't blow me away. It was good, but it didn't blow me away, so.
I mean, we've definitely been seeing them get progressively better, and I guess, as you were saying, maybe you're expecting the beginning to be as good as we're seeing now.
Yeah.
Right.
I agree with you guys that the first three seasons are definitely the crews I think of when I think America's Best Dance Crew. No offense to the other winners, that's just what I think of. Because you have Jabberwockies who, I mean, they were just so memorable. They were probably, and that might be why they were such a good crew to have as a first season crew, because they are so memorable in the way they did their masks.
Right.
People still talk about them.
Right.
They're in Vegas. You can go check them out. Yeah. They have a show, their own show.
Right. So people still talk about them, even though they were taking from Korean breakdancers. That was a Korean breakdancer thing. Whatever. I'm just saying
that
because nobody else gives them credit. I'm just saying it. I just want to, now that I had the chance, to give them credit. Jabberwockies are great. I love them. And we've seen them in, like, movies like Step Up 2.
Right.
And we've seen them in other places. And it's always so memorable. And the first time that people think of dancers or hip-hop dancing, you ask anyone, they're going to say Jabberwockies. That's what they think of.
Right.
So I think that's definitely the best possible crew that you
could
have.
And Quest Crew. I am a big fan. Were they there on set on Friday, by the way?
Only Steve was on set.
Oh, okay.
Which, he's the one who has spiky hair. I guess the spikiest hair.
I was like, wait.
They kind of all allowed them to do weird things with their hair. I'd say he has kind of the most normal spiky
hair. Okay.
But he's super nice. I got a chance to talk to him because I also practice with him sometimes. And he's a great guy, super nice. He actually just injured himself on set for Battle of the Year, which is a breakdance movie that he's been part of. So
Dave, we want to see you on the show.
Yes, Dave.
Not as good as them. Not as good as them.
If only
I was that good. But, they're great. And the other crew for me was Super Crew. I love being a B-boy.
Oh, yeah.
And
Super
because group. Those were some of the best B-boys in America together, forming a crew together. So that was cool to see. I still remember their sign, which was this. So that's all I was doing all of season two. You're making the S with it. So
I'm like,
I still got it.
It's S for Sarah. I can't even do it.
I'm like, what am I doing?
But I do think that this is a good season. I do like a lot of the dancers.
Yeah.
And I think that they've all been really strong. We've seen a lot of great crews coming through. What do you guys think in terms of next week? Who do you guys think is going to be in the bottom two and what we're going to see?
Oh, my gosh. It's so hard.
It is tough. But honestly, I want Most Wanted and Electrolytes to be the top two.
Yeah.
I
don't know why. I just have a feeling that they're going to throw 8 Flavors under the bus a little bit.
Under the bus, but I think because they are still starting out in their depth
they're not going to.
In comparison to these, you know, seasoned choreographers and Electrolytes, who are also very talented and are more experienced, I think they're going to let them be at the top. And maybe next season they'll bring back A-Flavors, just like they brought back Fanny Pack.
I mean, but if you think about it, they definitely don't necessarily need it as much for a boost to their career because they have so much longer to go.
Right.
Whereas, like, Electrolytes, the most wanted, could benefit more at right. this point in their lives.
But then again, everyone thinks that. So maybe they'll throw a curveball, and it'll be A-Flavors and Electrolytes battling each other.
Right. I think... I guess
I really want those two to be the top.
But I mean, who, based on popularity and based on who you think did the best this week, who do you think will be the bottom two next week? Guessing there is a bottom two next week.
Well, based on popularity alone, Most Wanted has the largest fan base, so that's like a given. But I don't think that they had out of. I really loved Electrolytes and A-Flavors this week. So
is that how they're going to do it? They're going to do a bottom two for the last. Three or?
Well, we've got two more episodes, I believe, right? So next week, I don't know if that's how they're going to do it, but I'm imagining there'll be a bottom two next week, and then that makes we have a final two crews for the last episode.
Mm-hmm. In the bottom, I would say not Most Wanted. They have the largest fan base. Everyone, I mean, LA is crazy for them.
Yeah.
So I would say Electrolytes and A-Flavors, bottom two.
I mean, I guess given off of what I hope happens, I think Electrolytes should be safe.
And I think so, yeah.
And Most Wanted and A-Flavors should be in the bottom. Given popularity's sake, I almost feel like Electrolytes and A-Flavors would be the ones in the bottom, just given popularity's sake. But I would hope Electrolytes, because they have been doing so well the past few weeks, are going to be the safe ones.
I agree. Based on performance, Electrolytes would be safe. Based on popularity... Most Wanted, definitely.
Yeah.
Agree.
Well, I'm glad we're in agreement.
Yay! High five to that. We're never the best. Yeah.
Finally, now that there's only three crews left, we're actually agreeing with each other about things. So, I guess, should we talk a little bit about just being backstage then and what that's been like since we've been doing it now regularly?
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, you're back there and you're vibing with the crews and the energy is just bananas because, you know, it's kind of a little bit... It's interesting to me because you would think that the crews would be tense and, like, kind of, like, in their head trying to get ready for the performance. But they're goofy. They're back there playing around. And I know I got to interview Electrolytes last week, and they were, like, doing their robot around me. And I'm like, what the heck? What's going on? So it's fun. It's a lot of energy back there. I love it. How did you feel? How do you feel about it?
I think one thing that I noticed is that they really do seem like they're busy, busy, busy nonstop because – whenever we go talk to them, they kind of are, as we're waiting, we kind of have to wait around for them. And then as we finally get time to go interview and talk to them, they're just rushing in, like, still finishing their dinner, eating sandwiches, and press interviews. And then right after that, they have to perform. And that's just one day of their week. So I can't even imagine how busy they are. But that's always what kind of makes me think of is like, wow, they are so busy. They must have such nonstop busy ghost
schedules. You get a taste for the pressure that these crews actually experience when they're shooting these shows. It's balancing everything. The girls, even like RNG and A-Flavors, they have homeschool that they deal with, and they were even late to set a little bit later to the media room that one day because they had just come from schooling, so they're leading these crazy lives where they're packing everything in, they're dealing with shoots, they're dealing with rehearsals, they're dealing with interviews, they're dealing with us, they're dealing with everybody else that's in the media room,
and they're still so upbeat.
It's absolutely nuts.
Another
thing that I think is cool is we get to meet other celebrities or media outlets who are big ABDC fans, and we can talk to them. I know we talked to a few celebrities about who they think is their fave. So it's just interesting to see all these people come together supporting the talent of these crews.
Yeah, I totally agree. I think it's just great seeing it. It's also just seeing fans of the show come together when you're back there. And as you were saying, the media outlets are fun to talk to. Celebrities who are there who are fun to talk to. So it's definitely a blast just to be around like-minded people who are doing the same thing.
My favorite little guy backstage is actually the little kid, the little baby that runs around. He's like, I don't know, two, but he's actually the son of one of the guys in Electrolytes. So, a little baby. Yeah,
baby.
He's so cute.
All right, guys. Well, that does it for this week's show. We've been having a great time doing it. Definitely catch us next week at our normal time, Wednesdays, 8 p.m., right after the show airs. You can check us out talking about live. Join the live chat. Yes. We will probably have a guest joining us, and you can ask them questions. AfterBuzzTV.com to check it out.
And thanks for tuning in today as we broadcast live at
the Hollywood
in Hollywood for MTV Movie Awards.
All right, guys. So, again, I am Dave Klein. You can find me on Twitter at TheDaveKlein, that's K-L-E-I-N, or DJK-online.com.
Hey guys, all right, so you can tweet me at Tweet Nina Marie. That's TweetNinaMarie.
And you can follow me at Sarah Mendoza, SaraMendoza. Find me on Facebook too.
Awesome.
And guys, I'm being critical overall, but all these crews are amazing. I just need to throw that out there. They're all good.
We love them.
And Sarah and Ronnie, would you like to, or Sarah's over there. Sarah, would you, not Sarah, I'm sorry.
Marissa,
would you like to?
I am Marissa Movies on Twitter.
All right.
Check her out.
All right, guys, thank you so much for joining us.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other After shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
Aloha.